to a presentation about continuous delivery workflow with Gerrit. This was supposed to work. My name is Piotrek Tomiak. I'm a product architect of MyEclipse. I'm from Genuitech. We are Eclipse Foundation members since 2003 or 4. And besides being a product architect, I also do a lot of other stuff. And well, let's dive into the presentation. As probably everyone knows, continuous delivery is a really cool thing. You can deliver to your customers as soon as your features are ready, tested. It also makes it easier for your team because you don't have so much pressure, right? If it doesn't make a fix or feature, it doesn't make a particular release. Well, then you'll release it in 1 week, on the next day or 2 days, right? So there is less pressure on the team, and it's also working in favor of a quality for the software. You're not have to be in hurry. So the feature lifecycle in continuous delivery is, as you would imagine, a perfect way of doing features, right? You specify, you develop, you then build the feature, but only that particular feature, you get it tested, and then of course you get some bugs, so you go back to develop, build, test. And once the feature is ready, you release it, right? So that's how would you like to have your software delivered. I'm gonna focus on develop phase mostly. I'll also cover how we do build and test phases in my Eclipse team, but I will cover mostly on the develop phase because that's an important phase, because if your code is if your code workflow how you develop code is not nicely done, then you can have a perfect build testing environment, but you will still not be able to continuously deliver the software. So we do Git, and probably, I guess, who is not doing Git? Okay. So, well, even if you're not doing Git, then this might be a good thing in other. What kind of repositories do you use?
Yeah.
Sorry?
Subpatch.
Okay.
BGC and Dennis.
Okay.
Okay,
so probably that's a well-known diagram of how you do a successful Git branching model, and well, yeah, it's cool, right? But there is this develop branch on which you develop all your fixes, features, everything, right? Well, except for features. But you see, if you develop and you have a regression or some problem with your fix, you can test it only when it's merged with the develop branch, right? So this leaves you to a very convoluted kind of model where you have multiple fixes and a single build, single test phase. So you can release those only if all of them are good, right? That's not cool, because it's not a continuous delivery process. So the important thing is to, you know, you have to test before merge it with the stable, with the release branch. And that's where you have, for example, GitHub approach with pull requests. You do a code review for your pull request. You have a separate build for each pull request. You can test it. You can iteratively improve it by putting code on it. So it's cool. You can do continuous delivery with pull requests. But that's from one of the project's BERT repositories. So if you can see, it's like, yeah, it's cool, but why do those merges here? Why do you need fix compile errors here? It's really hard, for example, to revert such commit there, then, because you have to revert first this one, for a second this one, and then this one, right? It's also like really hard to read history and to, for example, cherry pick, because you which branch is this commit on, and you want to check cherry pick it, for example. So it's not that cool if it comes to managing such a repository, right? It's probably really great for a small open source project where you don't have a lot of contributions. But if your team has like 6 or 10 members and they are constantly committing stuff, then you get a huge mess. So that's why my personal preference is with rebase and amend. Why? Because you only merge quality commits. You work on a commit until it's tested, build it, its quality. You get a linear history, single commits, easy to revert. And of course, well, merges are four feature branches because that's an information which is kind of required, right? You have this, it's like feature branches are the things to be merged, not bug fixes. And therefore, some unimportant information is lost. So the thing which provides such abilities is Gerrit. Who doesn't know about Gerrit? Who doesn't know what's Gerrit? Okay, so just so then I'll just do a very quick overview of what Gerrit is. If, oh man, that was supposed to be shown on that screen. Just a second, sorry. Screen setup is messed.
If anything, you could maybe do a personal demonstration to whomever.
Yeah, probably because
I
planned to do some demos, but I was set up for HDMI, and here is the analog input, and I cannot move the screen out. I cannot move it to the other screen. That's pretty bad. Sorry for that. So let's get back to the presentation then. Something, there's always something which has to go wrong, right? Come on. Okay. We're back on track. So basically, Gerrit is a review system. Every commit which your developers push to Gerrit, it shows on a dashboard, and before the commit can be merged with the with the branch for which it is supposed to be merged with, you have to get a code review for it. So someone else has to code review, and you have to get it verified. So it means that it has to go through automated test or through manual test. So we in MyEclipse we do both, automated and manual test. And our history looks like this, and that's a very similar flow which you would get with the BERT repository over there. For most of the time, it's just linear. It's very easy to see what has changed, at what time it was merged, and it's also easy if you have troubles with someone doing something a year ago, you just see what was the whole change he did. It's not split for 3-4 commits, and then you have to figure out what to revert, what he did. So I think that's a really cool flow. And so with Gerrit, you naturally work with changes, right? You push a commit, you work on change. But we needed feature branches as well for features which take longer to develop, which require multiple commits, or collaboration from multiple committers. So we've came up with a very simple but yet very efficient flow where we separate work on the two categories. A local change branch, that's how we call, if you work on several bug fixes, you have to create local branches for each of them to be able to switch, right? If your bug fix you made on a day one doesn't get verified, for example, then your bug fix number two cannot be dependent on that one. You have to develop it on a separate branch. So that's what we call change branch, because if you push to your stable release branch, you get a change from it. Now, you also have a feature branches, and those exist in the Gerrit repository. Those are visible for everyone. And on those feature branches, you commit multiple commits. They just go through commit code review before being merged. So you and for a very simple smoke test, automated smoke tests, like whether it compiles or whatever. And then you do a verification, automated or manual, of whole feature branch. And that's usually on demand. So when a developer says, well, this feature branch is ready for testing, then we fire it. Because you know it would be not too efficient to do those tests for each feature branch with every commit. Because usually those feature branches are unfinished, right? Then for changes which are visible on Gerrit as a change, we do code review, and then it goes for a build. So each change is built, it's tested manually and automatically, and once it gets verified plus one, that's when it's submitted and it's rebased, it's not merged. So you get a nice linear history and you know at which point the change, which change get into the build. Once any either feature branch or change branch gets to the stable branch, we again verify it with much more with bigger tests, right? Usually you would do kind of a focus test in one area. You wouldn't test everything if you have a change or a feature branch, because well, that might be very inefficient and you might even not be able to do it. So the verification happens in a stable build. We try to make with this approach, you merge to your release branch only stable changes, like they are tested. And if you build them, we kind of simulate merge with master, and only then we build. So it's not like they are built on the feature branch; they are built after being merged. So that also ensures that there are no conflicts with current code, and the branch is ready for being merged. And well, once it's really once it's verified, we release it. So this is how the workflow with Gerrit branching works. And well, as you can see, it's much simpler than the previous one. And you see that those change branches, those commits on the change branch, they are rebased. They are not merged. So the final history looks like this. And I think that, well, if the simple solution handles all your problems, that's the better solution, right? So, yeah. Who likes feature branches with Gerrit? Who are, right? And how do you do feature branches with Gerrit?
With the eGet for integration.
Okay. And does it configure your repository for push to upstream?
Partially.
Okay, yeah, so we probably have to do push to Gerrit, right?
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah, so in our team, we came up with something we called a Gerrit workflow for Eclipse. In the beginning, it was just eGet tools just to automate some processes. But then we came up with a simple plugin, but which automates your workflow. You got those three things: switch to stable branch, feature branch, and chain branch. And you can create a new feature branch. It I'll try to demonstrate it. I hope it will work. So when you create a new feature branch, it automatically fetches your master, and because that's one of the common mistakes, for example, you create a feature branch from your outdated master, right? You have pulled repository like 2-3 days ago, and you create a feature branch. It's already outdated, right? It already might require merges for the build to pass. So there are some automated process which makes it more robust and more kind of, let's say, secure, right? It also, when you use those methods, it updates the push to upstream, so the ref specs for push, so you automatically can, you know, type in commit, change ID, and commit and push. That's very cool, right? Your developers doesn't have to think that, well, now I have to push to that branch, and now I have to push to that branch, and type those branches manually, right? You get you create new changes, and when you create a new change, we basically use one stable branch master. But if you have to manage several releases, release streams like 11, 12, 13, then you probably will have multiple stable branches. And you can choose which branch you want to work on, and when you, it will automatically configure push to upstream for that particular branch. So there will be no something like you push to not that version because you kind of like you made a mistake and you push to the different version, right? One of things we integrated with Mylan a bit. This is an optional feature, so it will list you all the changes which are open in the particular repository, and you can just easily check them out and work on them. So you can see it detects which branch is the change on. So for example, in cases where your change has a merge conflict, you can check it out from Gerrit through this, make changes. Or do pull automatically, and it will do the pull with your master. It will work. And some additional features like tag multiple repositories or import export Gerrit project set, because like we found out that the eGit tools, it's kind of hard to manage project sets with Gerrit because the ref specs are not correctly set. Or everyone has a different username, for example. So, so this is also a good utility. And well, since this is a sponsored talk, so you probably think that this is something we sell, right? No, it's free and open source. You can get it on GitHub. You can get it on Marketplace. And we are it's something we developed internally. So it is kind of suited for our workflow, but we are definitely open to making it more more available. Like, for example, well, we have features under features, refs heads features. We have changes under refs heads changes. But maybe in your flow you would like to have a bit different name of branching. I don't know, whatever. We're open for contributions and for suggestions on how to further evolve this. And. Well, I hope I will be able to show you at least a bit. Yay! Here we go. Okay, that's gonna be interesting. Okay. So, so here it's like how it works. You have multiple feature branches, and for example, if I switch to this feature branch. My config push specification is automatically configured for push to upstream, and also when you check out change branches, feature branches, for example, something very simple, but rebase is set to true, right? We don't want your pull to do merges with when you work with Gerrit, for example. So there are a lot of simple utility things which help to get it working nicely. That's on the code side. Now, I just wanted to very very quickly say about how have we managed build, test, and release phases. Of course, it's not a real continuous delivery. We deliver our software each 3 weeks to our users, but because we have changed the way how we code, we have, as I said, less pressure on the team and more quality and less regressions. So even though we are not still able to do real continuous delivery workflow, a partial improvements have in that direction have helped us really, really well. So we do regular builds, and that's for MyEclipse and WebEclipse. We do using Maven, Hudson, and Maven is to build plugins, export them. Then Hudson manages that process, and we use Secure Delivery for MyEclipse to package that and manage installations. It builds installers and manage other stuff. So that's our say proprietary software. And such a build takes 1 hour. MyEclipse has 650 plugins to build. So the export itself takes like a half an hour. Now, therefore, we had to come up with our, let's say, custom solution where we detect for each change which features plugins have changed, and we export only those modified plugins. We create an update site with an updated feature versions, and then this is installable to a regular stable build of MyEclipse. We also use SDC here to ensure that the update is later on uninstalled correctly, because if you use just P2 and you install something, it might not remove the plugins you have installed with that feature. It will leave the newer version. So that helps us ensure that we test what we should test. Testing, we have some JUnit tests. We mostly use QF tests. MyEclipse is UI based, so we do a lot of UI testing. A lot of that is automated, but since it's a vast environment, we also have a lot of manual testing, and from that manual testing, test cases are created in TestLink, we've just migrated from Testopia, which result later on in automated tests. So if we, so that's how that's the flow of the testing. And well, we release using SDC for MyEclipse, and for WebEclipse we use Eclipse Marketplace. And we've made also a very cool small plugin which we called Evergreen. So it reads a manifest in the internet, right, and compares the versions of IUs of plugins in that manifest with those installed in your Eclipse. That's a very, very fast process. And then once it's it detects that, well, the versions are different, we just run the P2 update, which is slow because it has to download all the artifacts, stuff like that. So we can quickly check and update. And it's also happening in the background, so the updates are installed once the user restarts Eclipse. Yeah, and that would be it. And I guess Emmanuel will say what's next in this Gerrit workflow thing for you.
All right. So in regards to Gerrit workflow, what's next? You can obviously use Gerrit. It's available. It's something that we can facilitate as well as a standalone product with WebEclipse, which is something that I've given each and every one of you. I believe you don't have it. This is our new baby, WebEclipse. This is something that can help you with JavaScript debugging, for example, or REST inspect. Gerrit workflow as well is included in here. And of course, when it comes to MyEclipse, if I'm not mistaken, that's where we've kind of spoken already about this, but they integrate well together. WebEclipse is something that you can get, all of you, for free. This is a freemium-based solution. And hopefully it can showcase a little bit of what it is that we do, our professionalism when it comes to software, and what it is that we were able to write. And we invite, obviously, all of you to give WebEclipse a try to see what it is. It doesn't cost you anything. You just install it, look at it. It's a plugin for Eclipse. You can find it in the marketplace. And after that, give us your feedback. Obviously, we need your feedback in order to develop better, you know, more useful features and whatnot. The one that's the most useful right now, which I believe, help me out here, but I think that the JavaScript debugger is probably the most useful feature out there, because there's no JavaScript debugger right now. So yeah, we're kind of the only ones doing it. So hopefully you guys are going to enjoy it. And if you don't need it, then share it with someone that might use it, might need it, you know. So, all right. Now,
well, it was supposed to say questions.
Yes.
Any questions?
Any questions for us?
Yes. Did you consider to automate your Eclipse improvements?
Well, probably not at that moment, because it's kind of a very well, it's kind of matured, but I don't know whether it is what people would like to have, right? I mean, once we get some feedback, maybe that's gonna be viable to contribute it to IGIT itself, like the flow, Git flow is part of the IGIT distribution. So, so yeah, that's something we considered, but I think the it's much easier to first get the software in a good shape on GitHub, and then of course in a collaboration with someone from IGIT is if it's interesting for the project, and yeah.
There is many things on the actual IGIT, the last version of the IGIT plugin. There is a lot of thing for using Gerrit and automatically using Gerrit. So the push to Gerrit is within. Before we were using the refor and so
mm-hmm.
on. So there's. They're working too on
okay.
the Gerrit.
Yeah, so that's also why. It's something we did internally. Just when we were publishing it, the eGerrit solution has also happened to emerge. So I hope it's useful, but it's also like you said, maybe. In 1-3 months, IGIT will already have those features,
yeah.
And then it's not gonna be that super cool. So, But yes.
For the continuous integration with Linux Delivery Pub, how awesome work? Do you build only the master branch or every changes you have a separate build for the cloud?
Yeah, so we do the full build, the regular build, only on master branches. For changes and feature branches, we do those delta builds. I've developed kind of a P plugin development PDT based solution, which exports only those plugins which have modified, and. Then it builds this update site, which we install into a regular build. And besides of the feature configuration, the code is exactly the same as it would do as it would be with a regular build.
Okay. And then, if the build is success, you get the evaluation to Gerrit.
Yes. So the automated system consumes the build. SDC is able to. Even to install, to automatically update the Eclipse with a configured update, and then the automated test would run. And also, we would run some manual tests because usually, especially if that is a new feature, the UI flows are not covered in automated cases immediately. So someone has to manually verify it. And once that's done, the verified plus one or minus one goes to Gerrit. And we also use a Kanban flow we've just recently switched to Kanban, and that plays really well with the Gerrit workflow.
Can I ask you
about
the tool and the
clean
tool thing that checks the delta builds?
Mm-hmm.
Is it available or is it a proper solution?
Yeah, we don't know whether it's going to be interesting. Because it's very, it might be very, very suited specific to our solution.
Uh-huh.
But if you're interested in it, just come to the booth. We're on the other
mm-hmm.
side of the right there, and I'll show you and talk about it. Maybe you'll be interested in. We'll see what comes from it.
So you have the Edson is a reviewer. You manage to connect your Gerrit with your Hudson, and Hudson is automatically a reviewer. of your
yeah,
your
the
change?
This QA build is what I call is between for the changes, because Hudson build would be if we would do a full regular build with Hudson, it would take 1 hour to build the change.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. So so for changes, and that's why I say it's like kind of a
you
hack solution.
You are using another thing than Hudson.
Yes.
But it's a reviewer. On
yeah. The
Gerrit
reviewer
change.
The reviewer is connected. I have it opened here, so maybe I'll be able to. The connection is lost. Wait. Maybe I'll be able to show. So basically, we have this instead of Hudson for the change and feature branches, we have this solution which is based on Eclipse. Yeah.